Hey guys, I'm Matt with Boreas Campers here in Denver, Colorado. We're gonna do a rundown here on our build process. All of our campers are zero wood construction. We're gonna go through why we don't build with plywood and also why we don't use an aluminum box. First and foremost, with our fiberglass exterior, it has a much better thermal expansion and thermal transfer tendencies than aluminum does. So what that means is it's not gonna be expanding and contracting like an aluminum or a plywood system. And it's also not gonna transfer temperatures like aluminum or plywood would. So that means it's gonna be cooler in the summer and warmer in the winter inside of your cabin. It also means a significantly reduced amount of condensation when you are doing those deep winter camping trips. In terms of repairability, when you scratch a camper that has an aluminum wrapped system, you cannot repair a scratch on aluminum. It's permanent, it's always gonna be there. You just kinda have to slap your favorite sticker on it. With the fiberglass, that can be repaired. You can either do it in your own garage with a buffer. If you've got years and years of trail rash and scratches on it, you can take it to your boat and RV shop, have it polished up, looking showroom new again. If you ever to get a puncture in the fiberglass, you put a tree branch through it, there's an accident, something happens, this is also again repairable. When you get into the plywood and the aluminum systems, those punctures are not repairable. You can't weld aluminum when there's insulation behind it. And same with, you cannot weld aluminum when there's plywood behind it. We switched from plywood construction back in the beginning of 2018. It was the greatest move we ever made. It puts us into another category of quality, strength, and building a lighter trailer. Another benefit to our fiberglass panel system is its resistance to rock dings and also hailstorms. That's been kind of a significant issue around the nation lately. We had a situation at a dealership where we were sitting right next to an aluminum wrapped trailer. All of those trailers were totaled out in a hailstorm. Our trailer's sitting right next to it, same storm, zero damage whatsoever. All right, and here I have the two examples of the systems that we use for the construction of the camper. This is an example of what's gonna be our walls and our roof. So this is an insulated foam core. We have the composite fiberglass panel here, and what sets us apart from what you typically see in a fiberglass camper is the thickness of this sheet. This is 1/8 inch thick. That's 0.125. That is almost double, if not more, depending on the manufacturer, of other fiberglass sheets. So we go into the resistance to hail, scratching, rock dings, trail damage, things like that. On the other side of it, we have our maple panel. This is a FRP, which is a fiberglass reinforced plastic. Again, this is not wood, not one sliver of wood in any of our campers. This is easily wiped down, wash mud and dust and anything off of it, and it's gonna be lighter and stronger than a typical plywood or aluminum system. All right, and then our second system that we use on the campers here are our honeycomb floor. So this has a nice diamond plate rigid top to it. And then on the underside, which would be the belly of the camper, is again a full seamless fiberglass system, repairable to trail damage, anything like that. And these systems are incredibly rigid. It'll last a lifetime. All right, thanks for checking us out, guys. If you're looking for more detailed information on this, check out our blog post on the website, Aluminum versus Fiberglass. And of course, any questions, give us a call, shoot us an email. Thanks.